This is the MonDak Oilfield Review with host Jason Spies.
My name is Jason Spies, and this is the MonDak Oilfield Review, heard in the Crude Life Media Network. On today's episode, we talk with Shaun Sipma, Minot City Alderman, about Bakken hub cities and the importance of financing. In just a moment, Shaun Sipma, Minot City Alderman, on the importance of Bakken hub cities and the financing, right here on the MonDak Oilfield Review. It seems everywhere I go these days, someone is telling me about the success of Hatch Coaching. Listen to what professional speaker Mark J. Lindquist has to say.
He is a person in this market and now in markets across the country with Hatch Coaching that is revolutionizing the way people approach the business. He's reinventing the way people look at the people model. That's why he brings in hundreds of people from all over the country who are trying to figure out how to do what he's doing in their market.
For more information, call 701-212-1572 or visit coachingwithhatch.com. That's coachingwithhatch.com. Welcome back to the MonDak Oilfield Review, heard in the Crude Life Media Network. My name is Jason Spies. Up next, Shaun Sipma, Minot City Alderman, on the importance of Bakken hub cities and their financing. How do you educate and cross those bridges, I guess, being in Minot?
Well, I think if you take a look at North Dakota's economy, we are diversifying our state as an economy. You know, you take a look at Fargo, they've kind of got their own self-driving engine now with the different facets of it. We're still working in western North Dakota to diversify our economies, because if you look at what we're heavily reliant on, it's commodity, it's agriculture, and it's energy. Now, that's a great starting point. We really have a unique ability to host some of those manufacturings, to build some of those other facets that can create that self-driving engine and not be so heavily reliant on the different commodities. Now, with UAS, you know, Grand Forks has got a nice little piece of that at the Grand Forks Air Force Base. But when we talk about the nuclear triad, we've got two legs of that between the bombers and then the ICBMs right here in Minot. We have a significant investment within the bombers, and what we really do hope are the future next generation after the B-52s, if they're ever retired. You know, it seems like they keep retrofitting those. I think they're good until the 2044, if memory serves correct, but that plays a significant role within the economics of the region, but also offers up a tremendous opportunity, which I think we have yet to fully realize when it comes to what our state can provide to national security beyond just the realm of the base itself.
Once again, that was Shaun Sipma, Minot City Alderman. To listen to the full-length interview with Shaun Sipma or other energy features, visit our website, thecrudelife.com. That's thecrudelife.com. The MonDak Oilfield Review is part of the Crude Life Media Network. Check us out on Facebook and Twitter. Be part of our ever-growing social media audience, which is now over 350,000. And all of our social media links are available at thecrudelife.com. From the staff of the MonDak Oilfield Review, my name is Jason Spies, asking you to be happy, be safe, and keep it turning to the right.